Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is the Symbiotic Cubes. What you see here is two Rubik's Cubes that are almost fused together. And I call them Symbiotic Cubes because each of these two Rubik's Cubes are fully functional Rubik's Cubes and they work while they're merged together. So let's start with this Rubik's cube. It's a regular 3x3. Ignore this part, let's just assume it's shaved off. And what I can do is turn it as if it were a regular Rubik's cube. And well, you see, even though it looks a bit shape-shifting, it is essentially a 3x3 Rubik's cube. So that is the red, yellow, blue Rubik's cube. We also have a Rubik's cube at the other side, the green, orange, white, and also that one works as a fully functional Rubik's cube. So there we are. Here we make one move, and I can make more moves. Well, the thing is a bit floppy, that's because of the mechanism. There we are. And here we see that the other Rubik's cube can be scrambled as well. And when you look at the detail, it's a bit hard to see. All of these parts have been linked together with dovetail connections. Here you perhaps see them better. So these are little hooks that grab together. So I'm going to put it back in shape. And the fun of this puzzle, it's actually quite interesting to scramble. What you do is scramble and solve one of the Rubik's cubes. However, you can interchange edges. So for instance, this edge you can put there. And this corner you can get there. So you can solve the puzzle in shape, but not in stickers. And then you scramble the other cube. And ultimately you get the thing horribly scrambled and quite difficult to solve. Oh, and I'm going to show you yet another interesting feature of this puzzle. Since it is using dovetails, you can make this whole offset configuration where it looks like it's falling apart, but actually it's quite stable together despite the looseness of the dovetails. So, well, here you have a staircase shape. The question that I have about this puzzle is that you've seen this little circular marker at each of the sides of the puzzle. And my question to you is, why did I put that marker there? Thank you for watching.